A renowned zoologist and educator for more than 50 years, George H. Waring IV, Ph.D., knew early on what kind of career he wanted to pursue. Growing up around the rocky, scenic mountains of Colorado, Dr. Waring gravitated toward education and nature in his formative years, during which he became an expert on dog sledding and handling, as well as the general behavior of animals. He worked for a family business that took care of more than 60 dogs at a time. His employer, Stuart Mace, served in World War II as an organizer of dog sledding for the military, traveling throughout the Arctic and purchasing dogs on behalf of the Army, whose intention for the dogs was to help with rescue work and gather supplies. Once the war ended, Mr. Mace took the remaining dogs and formed his business. Through the job, Dr. Waring often led tours through the kennels and became well-versed in several subjects, including botany. Mr. Mace was a graduate within the field and shared his knowledge any chance he could. Naturally, the job shaped the young Dr. Waring and his future aspirations. Motivated by discovery and wanting to spend his life examining the behaviors of a variety of animals, a relatively new field at the time, he dedicated himself to studying. In the midst of his 8-year service with the United States Coast Guard Reserve, beginning in 1957, he earned a Bachelor of Science from Colorado State University in 1962, and subsequently a Master of Arts in Biology from the University of Colorado in 1964. In pursuing the master's degree, he studied the behaviors and sounds of marmots, specifically the yellow-bellied marmot. This kind of thorough research on the animal, which entailed living amongst them for a summer, recording their calls and decoding what each meant, writing detailed notes on their vocabulary, and being able to decipher the many meanings behind the sounds based on that information, had never been done before. By 1966, he had obtained a Doctor of Philosophy in Animal Behavior and Zoology from Colorado State University and began teaching as an assistant professor of zoology at Southern Illinois University. After 6 years, he advanced to an associate professor, a post he held from 1972 to 1984, while also teaching as a visiting professor at the University of Munich from 1972 to 1973. During this time, he served as the first director of the United States Marine Mammal Commission's research program in Washington, D.C., from 1974 to 1975. The program was an important conservation effort in which he played a major role in saving animal life and preceded the passing of the Endangered Species Act by a year. In 1984, he became a full-time professor and zoologist at Southern Illinois University, as well as an extremely active consultant within his field of expertise for numerous publishers, law firms, and agencies. Over the course of several decades, he taught courses on the diversity of animals, the natural history of vertebrates, ornithology, and animal behavior, among others. Dr. Waring has been recognized as a professor emeritus and continues to give lectures to local groups and find great joy in contributing to all kinds of scientific and conservation endeavors, often through the guidance of his graduate students. Among myriad crowning achievements throughout his career, Dr. Waring is especially proud to have been the first to publish about land mammals in scientific literature. Following his publication, others began studying land mammals as well. His doctoral work focused on 3 different species of prairie dogs, comparing each of them and their sound communications. On this front, Dr. Waring has most enjoyed doing fieldwork, examining the animals in their natural habitats, and documenting everything he observed. He has taken great pride in discovering what was going on in their lives, seeing how and why they reacted to things, and observing how they communicated with one another. As a testament to his early professional accomplishments, he was made a Deutsche Forschungsgemeinschaft grantee in 1972, a state and federal agency grantee from 1967 to 2006, a fellow of the National Institutes of Health in 1965, and received the F.C. Gene Research Award from the Colorado-Wyoming Academy of Science in 1965. In 1995, he was bestowed the Exceptional Service Award from the Animal Behavior Society, an organization he founded and served in as a parliamentarian. He has also been affiliated with the American Association for the Advancement of Science, International Society for Applied Ethology, American Ornithologists Union, and was made a life member of the American Society of Mammalogists. Looking toward the future of professionals who wish to succeed in his field, Dr. Waring noted that it is an especially fascinating area of study because, as he noted, you are answering the unknown. He encouraged that they not be timid about being curious and wanting to solve problems. A devoted husband to Anne Meredith, to whom he was married in 1962, father of three, grandfather of 15, and great-grandfather of 20, Dr. Waring hopes to be remembered by his colleagues as the Marmot Man, as his extensive research of the species was groundbreaking and significant in its time.